Good morning, students. So I'll be going to through the summary of chapter 2, digestion and the role of microbes. You're going to learn about teeth, how to take care of the teeth, the digestive system and the microbes in this chapter. The first one is teeth. Teeth are present in our mouth and they help in biting and chewing the food. There are two types of teeth, temporary and the permanent one. These are the temporary ones and these are the permanent ones. So temporary ones, by the time the child is 2.5 years old, the first set of 20 teeth appear. By the time the child is 2.5 years, these 20 teeth are called as the temporary teeth. They are also known as milk teeth. Now coming to permanent teeth, at the age of 6 years, the milk teeth starts to fall and new teeth appear, which are bigger than the temporary teeth and they take the place of the temporary teeth. This set of new teeth is called as the permanent teeth and there are 32 teeth in the new set. Now coming to the types of teeth, according to their function, teeth are of 4 types. Now incisors, these are the incisors. Here if you see this one, this is the incisor. Now canine, premolar and molar. If you see this pic here, these green color, this is the incisor. The canine, orange one is a canine and this one, this blue is your molar in the primary teeth. There are no premolars in the primary teeth. And in the permanent teeth, there are 8 sets of incisors, 4 canine, again 8 premolars and 12 sets, 12. Now coming to the next one, canine. There are 4 canines in all, 2 in each jaw. This teeth here, this is your canine, okay. And there are 4 canines in all. They are sharp and used for tearing food. If you see this, they are sharp here. So because of that only, if you see them in flesh-eating animals, you have bigger and sharper canines. This one. This is a teeth of a dog and it has a bigger and sharper canine. Here the lion also has a big and a sharp canine teeth if you see this pic here. Now coming to premolars, there are 8 premolars, 4 on the upper jaw, 4 on the lower jaw. This is your premolar, okay. They are broad teeth next to the canines and they are very broad on the surface here if you see this one. They help to crush food and chew it. With these teeth you crush the food and they help in chewing. Now coming to molars, these are the molars, okay. These two molars come first and then this last one, it comes at the last and this is also known as the wisdom teeth. There are 12 molars and bigger and flatter than premolars. They are big and flatter than the premolars. Now 8 molars, they grow fast, I told you. Plant eating animals have well developed premolars. So their premolars and molars are well developed in the case of plant eating animals because they need to chew and grind their food. Parts of the tooth. Now tooth has a crown and a root. If you see this part here, this is a crown and this is a root. This white portion here is called the enamel and it is the hardest substance in the body. Below the enamel comes the dentin. Below dentin is your pulp and pulp is the central part of the tooth. It has a lot of nerves and blood vessels. Okay, what is nerves now? Nerves are the part of the nervous system that take message to and from the brain to other parts of the body. What is blood vessels? They are again thin tubes through which blood flows. Now, care of teeth. How will you take care of your teeth? When we eat anything, tiny bits of food get stuck in spaces in between your teeth like this. In between your teeth, tiny food particles, they go and they get stuck. So, there what happens is germs start to grow and they form a yellow sticky layer. This is called the plaque. This yellow sticky layer here is called the plaque. So you can see inside the teeth also there are these germs and they are known as what? They are known as plaque. Now proper brushing with a toothbrush, toothpaste and water can help prevent plaque. The only way to prevent plaque is you need to brush your teeth at least twice daily. Now, ways to protect your teeth. Brush your teeth at least twice daily. Now, whenever you brush the teeth, upper teeth, you need to brush it downwards and the lower teeth should be brushed upwards. Brush at the back of the teeth, very important. Now, brush the flat surface of the premolars and molars. Always use a tongue cleaner to clean your tongue. Rinse your mouth after meals. Whatever food material is stuck in between your teeth will come out if you rinse your mouth. Always rinse after your meals. Eat healthy food like milks, eggs, curd, etc. Avoid eating sweets and visit a dentist at least once a year. Now coming to the digestive system. If I say, what is digestive system? The process by which the food is broken down into a simpler form. This food is going to be broken down into simpler form so that it is absorbed by the body is called digestion. Okay, the process of breaking down the food into simpler form is called digestion. The organs which work together and help in digestion form the digestive system. Process of digestion. Now, process of digestion, it starts in the mouth. Food is broken down by biting and chewing. The chewed food is then mixed with the liquid called saliva. So, saliva comes from the salivary glands. Whenever you think of food also, the saliva comes into your mouth. So, what happens is the food is mixed with the saliva and this helps in the digestion. This is the first process which happens in your mouth. Now, coming to the next one, it passes from the food pipe. This is your food pipe. This long, thin tube is the food pipe and it reaches the stomach. Okay. Now, next is stomach. What happens is this sac-like organ here, this is the stomach. Okay, it is closed from here and it is closed from here. Now, next the food is further broken down here in the stomach and then it passes through the intestine. Now, coming to the small intestine. After the stomach, it comes to the small intestine. Here what happens is whatever, it is now broken down into simpler forms and now this nutrient is going to be absorbed by the blood and taken to the different parts of the body from the small intestine. Yahan se whatever nutrient is remaining in the food is going to be taken by the blood vessel into the body. Whatever remaining is then goes to the large intestine, which is not required by the body, reaches the large intestine here. Okay, what is liver now? What is liver? This brown portion here, this is your liver. It secretes juices. And these juices, they help in digestion. It secretes juices. And if you see this pic here, you see this. From the liver, it passes like this. And the juices are dropped here in the small intestine. At the beginning of the small intestine. And which helps in the further digestion of the food. Okay. Now coming to the large intestine, what happens here is the food that cannot be digested reaches here. Now, whatever remaining water is there is being absorbed from here. The body absorbs the water from the large intestine and whatever remaining is your feces. Okay, the waste is the feces that is further moved to the rectum here and the feces are removed from the body through the anus. The last part here is called the anus. Now, what are the healthy eating habits? You need to chew the food well and do not swallow it whole. You have to chew the food. Then only the first process of digestion will take place. Now, eat fruits and vegetables every day. They will provide vitamins, minerals and dietary fiber, which is very important. Always wash your hands before and after meals. You have to wash your hands before and after meals so that you are away from germs. Now, rinse your mouth well. Very important, you need to rinse your mouth so that the food particles, they get rinsed away. Okay, always try to eat a balanced diet. Eat clean, fresh and well-cooked food. Okay, microbes. Now, microbes are tiny living things that are found all around us. Everywhere you can see microbes. You are not able to see microscope with your naked eye, but you can see it through microscopes. They live in water, soil, air, everywhere. Even our body, there are millions of microbes. Now, there are some which don't make us sick and there are some which make us sick. The most common types of microbes are bacteria, virus, fungi and protozoa. These are the pictures. Okay. This is a bacterial cell. This is a virus. These are fungi. Now, uses of microbes. Microbes are used in making bread. This is yeast. We use this. We activate this and we make bread. These are microbes. Now, microbes change milk to curd. They help to change milk to curd. They also help in digestion of the food. In our large intestine, there are a lot of microbes. They help in the digestion of food. Microbes help in the process of rotting of dead plants and animals. Now, coming to the examples of bacteria. Bacteria causes typhoid, tuberculosis and cholera. Now, I'm not going to explain all these. I've done it earlier. I'm going through the summary. Now, the virus examples are common cold, influenza and polio. So, I told you that common cold and influenza symptoms are same, but in influenza, it is severe. What is polio? These children, they are affected by the virus and which causes polio. Fungi. Now, this is a ringworm and this is a athlete's foot. Protozoa. Now, protozoa causes food poisoning, dysentery and malaria. So, with this, we come to the end of chapter 2. So, after vacations, you will be having a periodic test. Please learn chapter 1, 2 and 3. For holiday homework, you can draw the digestive system in your copies and please learn the same. Okay, that's it for today and have a wonderful vacation. Enjoy your vacations. Thank you so much.